So, and starting, I think me and Chamit, we usually go for wildlife safaris together. So he's one of my best friends. So we are here to talk about WSO2 Update Manager today. So before going into the details of the Update Manager, let's talk about our existing patching process. So if you are a WSO2 customer, you might have heard the word patch, and you might have received patches from our support team. So whenever you report issues, our support team basically deliver patches, fixes, that usually comes in the form of zip files. And when you unzip, there's a README and bunch of other jar files and configuration files, stuff like that. So what you usually do is you basically go through the README and apply steps one after the other. So that is usually a manual process, right? So that's what we have used to deliver patches and all that. So with Update Manager, we are trying to come up with a process where you can automate all that rather than you manually apply each and every patch to your production environment using a manual application process. See, other fact is there are pros and cons. The previous approach, whenever you report an issue, you will get the fix that basically solves that issue. But with Update Manager, you get all the issues. You get all the fixes that we basically fix for all the customers, not just for your issues, right? So sometimes I have personally heard some people they like it, because sometimes you don't know what's coming, right? If we give all the fixes, sometimes you might not need all the fixes. Sometimes you may need all the fixes. So it depends on the scenario, right? So the high level outline of this session would be, let's quickly go through what Update Manager, the licensing aspects, how it affects you, and then we will quickly go through how you can use Update Manager, various commands available, etc. And then let's talk about how you can utilize Update Manager in your production deployments and all that. So the primary purpose of Update Manager is to keep your products up to date. And whenever you try to use Update Manager for a specific product, for example, you want to update WSO2 ESB, or you want to update WSO2 API Manager. So when you try the commands, we will figure out which updates are new for you and which updates, and then we download and install them, and then we build you a complete new product. So when you go to WSO2 site, you download WSO2 API Manager zip file. That is the archive that we release. When you use WUM and update that, we install all the latest patches, latest updates, and give you a new zip file. And again, we send you an email, and what are the stuff we have installed, what are the updates available, and you can go through all the list of information. I will show you a sample email as well for your understanding. Right, so, and how it works is there is a backend running in WSO2 Cloud, which is now called WSO2 Integration Cloud. That is, this service is called WSO2 Update. So when you connect to Update with your WSO2 credential, WSO2 OT credentials, we figure out what are the updates that can be installed to your product. And then we download and install. The command line tool that runs on your machines, on your premises, is written using Go. And that is a very simple command line tool. The WSO2 Update service is written using Java and specifically using WSO2 microservices, MSF4J. That basically we have done a container-based deployment that is running in WSO2 Cloud. Right, so these are a bunch of supported products, and all the new products that will be released by WSO2 and will be supported by WUM. Right, so the update, let's look at the licensing effect. Right, so whenever we release archive, a product archive. Those products are open source and licensed under Apache 2. So you can do anything with it, basically. You can go to production. You don't have to pay us because it's free and open source. But the other side is when you use WUM to get updates, right, we give you non-open source code. So that is the only difference. So when you use WUM to update our products, the result, the new update distribution, it's not open source. And it is not licensed under Apache 2. It will be licensed under WSO2 update license. So these products, you are not supposed to use in your production environments if you don't have a WSO2 production subscription. You can use it in your non-production environment like test, your test environments, your dev environments. You can use all that. But if you don't have a paid WSO2 subscription, you are not supposed to use that in your production environment because that has not yet open source code. I'll explain what that means. So if you want to continue using 100% open source code without paying us, you can always go to our site and download the latest versions. So we'll make sure all the even the non-open source code at some point will be merged into all the releases that we do. So we usually do frequent dot releases, patch releases, minor releases of products. So all the bug fixes, we will eventually add it to our product releases. So in that case, you are safe. But if you have a like WSO2 paid subscription, you will get these fixes then and there, like maybe in 24 hours. Or less than that, depending on the complexity of the issue. So that is the added advantage that you get if you have a paid subscription, right? All right. So let's talk about how briefly go through like how you can use WUM. So this is a WSO2 API Manager download page. When you go to the download page, here you have several options. You can either download the API Manager archive, or you can download WUM. So here you can see there are some messages saying 39 updates available, basically, which means the API Manager, this exact version, there are 39 updates available. And these updates are not part of the download server. If you download the archive, those updates are not part of that archive. But you can get those updates if you download WUM and update API Manager. Right? So when you download WUM and try to install, it gives you your operating system specific installer. So this is like a Mac installer. You have a Windows and Linux separate installers, right? So it, and when you install, you go to a new terminal and you just type WUM. You can see all the available commands, right? A list of commands available. So the process is, the flow is, first, you need to have a WSO2 OT credential. I think if you're a customer, you anyway, if you are using our WSO2 support Jira, so you definitely have an account. So you enter the username password, and you will get authenticated. Basically, we authenticate with our WSO2 cloud and get access token, refresh token, and store that in your home directory. Next. Okay, so once you are authenticated with Update Manager, you can basically search products. Here we have a simple keyword-based search. So if you want to know like what products, what WSO2 products that are supported by WUM, you can basically search, for example, WUM search API, which would be WUM search ESB. Then it will give you a list of products that matches your search criteria. And then on your left-hand side, you can see like a key, which is like, let's say, WSO2 AM-analytics-210. So that is a unique string for that product. Right? So WSO2 AM-210, WSO2 AM-200, that's a unique key for that product. So you need to use that key for all other commands. For example, if you want to download the product, if you want to check for updates, if you want to update, you need to use that key, because that is, by using that key, we identify which product and which version. Right, so the next command would be WSO2Add. So the add command is, so there are two options here. You can either download products using our website. If I go back, you can download our products using our website by clicking the download server, or else you can download the product via WUM even. Like if you say WUM add WSO2AM210, we will download the product for you to your local machine. So this gives you easy access if you are in some Linux environments where you don't have access to UI or anything. You can just download the server to your remote machine using this. If you, given that you have internet access, you can download our products then and there directly, right? Or else, if you have already downloaded the product, you can do WUM add minus F the path in your file system. You can add the product. So the idea is, anyway, you have to add products to WUM. So WUM knows where your products are. So that's the only requirement. Okay. So when WUM knows the products that you want to update, then you can basically, first approach would be you can check updates. You can check whether there are updates for API Manager 2.0.0. Here, a sample output would be there are 69 updates available and 27 of them are critical security updates. So whenever there are critical security updates, we strongly recommend you to install them then and there, because those are security updates, right? So you can get this information from WUM for all the products that are supported. All right. So then the next step would be to actually install and generate a new archive. So when you type WUM update your product name, we will download all the products. And before downloading, we check whether you have a production account with us or paid W subscription that is searched based on your login credentials, your email, etc. We check, we cross-check whether you have a WSO2 subscription by visiting Salesforce, support Jira and all that. We figure out you have a production support account for this product. If not, we give you a warning saying your credentials are not associated, so you are not supposed to use these updates in a production environment, blah, blah, blah. So, and then we show how many updates and downloads and install, and then we give you a summary saying what happened actually. And so as I told you, if you look at below, you can see the updated products are added to your home directory. Here in my case, inside the .wumwso2 folder, you can always get the products. So there are other commands available where you can list and you can get products from this repository. And then once this update is successful, we will email you, we will give you a sample email, what we have added to your product. It contains a list of updates, what are the security updates, what are the other non-security updates, and also information, a brief information about each update. So you can go through these updates carefully. I think we encourage you to go through these updates description carefully, because then you know what you're applying if you want to push this new updated pack into the production. So here, so likewise, you will receive an email with a PDF which contains all these details. So our recommendation is to go through this PDF carefully, and sometimes this PDF contain instructions. So like in this example, these instructions may contain, if you want to enable this security feature, you need to do this configuration change like that. Right, so there are some features, some stuff, or some patches or some updates requires you to change configuration. So those information will also be available here. Okay, so now, so So that was like a very brief introduction to how to use WUM and basically play around, download updates, etc. Now the next topic, I think, where we get questions, concerns from most of our customers are this bit. How do I use WUM in my production deployment, and what are the complications? So without WUM, this is like a very simple way of managing WSO2 products. So you have your base product, for example, WSO2 API Manager, and then you have your customized config files which you are with your ports, URLs, and all that. And then the patches given by WSO2. So you combine all that, you come up with your customized distribution, and you push that to distribution to multiple nodes. So this is a very simple way of illustrating what you usually do, right? So this is without WUM. And if you get a new update, new patch from WSO2, so you have to usually go through the README manually and apply all the changes. So this might include changing your Puppet scripts, right? Because some patches we ask you to delete file, some patches we ask you to add this file, do this configuration change and everything. So you have to, that involves changing your Puppet scripts sometimes. I think some of you guys have encountered these cases. So this is all without patches, and then each and every patch you have to change some scripts, right? So that one thing. But let's see how WUM try to solve this issue. So this slide will explain how the product updates are generated. So you can see when you do the update for the first time, we get the base product, we add all the updates, and you get the product distribution, that is first update. And then when you do, let's say when you do the nth distribution, what we usually do is we get the product distribution, basically n minus 1th updated product distribution and all the new updates. So we don't, the current implementation of WUM usually get the last updated product, not the original product. So like you can keep updating, and we stores your history in our your home directory, and whenever we do the nth update, we always get the n minus 1th updated archive and add the latest one, updates. And you will get that email contains only the new updates, right? Yeah, so next, see how the diagram looks like. It's a very simple illustration just to show you how it works. Now you need to worry about only the base product. So we will give you a new base product. Previously, we give you patches, so you have to bake them into a distribution. But here now we give you a new base product with all the updates. Some files can be deleted, some files are added. So you don't need to worry about that. And all you have to do is apply your configuration files and push the changes. So you don't need to change your Puppet scripts or anything if you're using Puppet. So that's usually, I mean, so those are the things I want to talk about WUM in this session. I think when we talk to customers, there are more, they have more concerns using WUM. Maybe I think this is a good time. If you have any questions, we can go through them. So WUM is like very simple deployment. This is mostly it that I was planning to.